What's cooking, Juventus fans? Welcome back to your old lady's favorite YouTube channel, and I'm not going to mince words at all. I'm going to say what everybody is thinking when it comes to the match tomorrow. We're previewing it, but in reality, what we're doing is we're just all saying, let's get this bleep over with. Let's finish this record of a season and move forward to hopefully better times. Stick with us. We'll fill you in. Ciao ragazzi, welcome back to the Bianconeri Zone. My name is Justin Sofro. Today it is Sunday, June 4th, 2023. Of course, I got your latest rundown of all things Juventus, all the news you care about each and every single day. Before we do that though, do me a favor. Go ahead, if you could, smash that like button, hit the subscribe button, hit that bell icon to stay notified for all of our latest videos. And I'm going to go ahead once again, ask you all to please do me a favor. If you appreciate all that we have done here on the channel, all the slogging and getting through this miserable season, help me have some fun. Do me a favor, pop on over here to the Now We Can Talk Like Men podcast channel. Me, some other friends, hanging out, talking some random topics, sports, fun, gambling, bourbon. If you like bourbon, if you like any kind of alcohol, we will. If you want to be informed about bourbon, I am learning throughout this process. We're on episode 4 about to drop, and we're learning more and more about bourbon and the different tastes, the different ways that it's aged, and all the stuff behind it. Go ahead and check out our channel. We're having a lot of fun teaching people about bourbon, otherwise known as whiskey in other parts, but there's a special way we do it here in Kentucky. So if you could, go over there. Hit that subscribe button, tune in the channel, and then, of course, just letting you guys know, we are on the cusp of giving away a free Bianconeri Zone shirt. You know, the horse head shirt, black, white, green, whichever one you want. When we get to 100 subscribers, which you should do very shortly, we will be giving that away to one very lucky member. And we'll be doing plenty of giveaways here there on that channel as well. So, all right, let's go ahead and just get into it. What do we have the news today? Well, first of all, it's the game against Udinese. Of course, they decided to make this game as late as possible for us to have to wait till the end to get the season over with. I guess one positive is that they had already punished us and slammed Juventus with all the different ways that they could and the point deduction, so we know that Juve sit where they sit. All we really have to really play for, all the tiny little bit of hope, I guess, is you're trying to make Europa League, though I'll be honest, watching Europa League this season, outside of the potential of making your way to the Champions League and making sure that you can get yourself there, I don't need it. I don't need to have time for that. I don't. It doesn't do anything when it comes to players. It doesn't do anything when it comes to getting, you know, positive momentum. I guess that's what I was trying to get out. Positive momentum moving forward to me. It really just does none of that. All it does is kind of me is waste more time. Anyway, we're going to get into the preview, what Max Allegri had to say, and then I'll give you some of my two cents as we get through it, all right? Very first up, the very first commentary from Max Allegri. He goes on to say the group is doing well. We had good training sessions. We want to close well in Udinese after two defeats and try to get the Europa League. We have to play a good game. Udinese will try to beat us. I expect a reaction from the team, which has been working hard even the last few games, but the boys are not robots. The season has been tough. Sorry we could have played for the Champions League spot, but it didn't happen. Yeah, it didn't happen because of your failures as a coach, Max Allegri. It didn't happen because of the failures of the team that you put together, the players that you have and that you train each and every week. It's your job. It was your failure. Sorry doesn't cut it. Sorry doesn't cut it when you're getting paid, what, nearly 9 million euros a season? It does not cut it. I'm sorry. It doesn't fly for me as a Juventus fan to say, sorry we didn't make Champions League. That is the floor. The floor is Champions League. Anyway, like I said, him going off saying that he expects a reaction from the team. Why the hell would you expect a reaction from the team? If your team couldn't get up to beat the brakes off of Empoli and you watch yourself get your ass beaten and the brakes beaten off of you against Empoli, why would I believe that you're going to do it against Udinese in a game that does not matter? That in the end, it really doesn't. Outside of, yeah, you can get the Europa League. Who gives a shit about the Europa League? That's what you're going to get to. That's what you have to play for. I don't have any faith in these players. I don't have any faith in you as a coach that you're going to make it happen and get it going. So that's fine. Your words don't mean anything. Excuses, excuses, excuses. All right, let's move it on. That's only the first line. So let's continue on and see. Hopefully, I won't have an outburst every time. He goes on to say, at the end of the season, we will take stock, as we always do, whether we win or not. Next year, we will try to have a better season than this one. Yeah, hopefully, we will have a better season than this one. Hopefully, with you not at the helm of Juventus. Each of us will come out this year better in terms of strengthening balance. When things are going well, we should not get excited. When there are these moments, we should not be down. I don't even know what you just said. I want to quote the entire quote from Billy Madison. At no point in your incoherent whatever statement did you come to anything that he was even close to a what's the quote? You know what I'm talking about. At no point did you come to close to what I can call a coherent thought. Whatever, I award you no points. May God have mercy on your soul. Something along those lines. That's how I feel right now to Max Allegri for that comment right there. You cannot tell us that we came out better in strengthening balance or the team came out better at all at the end of this year. That is nonsense. This is the worst Juventus have done in over a decade. Get out of here. Continuing on, I understand. Points, what points we should have, we should be in second place or whatever it is at this point. That's fine. I'm sorry. That's not what it is, though. Let's continue on. I knew I would have a hard time winning, which means that Juve, when I came back, was under construction. It is different to have the ambition to always win, but I have always been very clear about that. Just as my enthusiasm is not in doubt. Okay, there he is trying to save his job. I don't really have any use for any of those comments. The players we are launching are an asset to Italian football. Next year we will be different, and tomorrow night we will figure out what competitions we will play. To start planning and to start again on July 10th. Again, I don't know. I don't have the time for Max Allegri and his planning and his future. There is no future with Max Allegri. If it's a Juventus that continues on with Max Allegri, I'm sorry. There is no future of winning with the club that I foresee for the next couple seasons then. We have to wait till the next guy because I don't believe it. Even with a guy like Gentile coming in who could have a bright future, bright ideas of getting players, whatever, I don't believe in Max Allegri. I'm done. He goes on to say, football is not an exact science. We have to analyze these 2 years with seriousness and professionalism, knowing that perfection does not exist. We have a very good base for next year, and to everything there is a solution. We must not get carried away by negativity, but everything will be evaluated from Monday. Okay, I agree with you there. We will, from Monday, after the game's over, we will evaluate a lot of things, and I'm hoping your future is one of them. I'm repeating myself at this point, but that's what I have for you. That's all I really have when it comes to Max Allegri, is he getting out of here? If not, what is your reasoning for keeping him on outside of he has a contract and we're going to have to pay him? That's all you have. Starting next week, we will know clearly what we are going to do next season. Technically, I guess that is true. I guess the fans will also know clearly what you are going to do next season. If you're still here, we know what to expect for next season. If you're not here, maybe there's a new hope. Anyway, starting the club that will make its assessments, thinking about the budgets that we have to be respected, I am convinced that we can have a very good season. In this whirlwind we've been going through in the last 15 days especially, we haven't talked about the future with the players, but we've been thinking about finishing the season well with the energy we have left, especially mentally. I don't buy that for a second. If you're going to tell me that nobody's thought about the future with the players, maybe the coaching staff hasn't, because they don't seem to look much more ahead than the, than I guess the next game, and even the which would be beneficial if you actually planned well for these games. But at the same time, you can't tell me when there's ideas and theories about Di Maria and his time at the club being done that they're not thinking about him. Like, I'm sorry, I don't buy that for one second that nobody's thought about the future of the players. Finally, the last part of this, he wraps it up with, we have anger and desire to start again. When you don't win, you are left with this. Otherwise, you become like many others for whom winning and losing is the same. We will have to put this anger on the field next year with balance, be protagonists until the end. Again, he said a lot of nothing there at the end. He tried to wrap it up, make it sound nice, and try to pass it off to the fans, to the management, whatever it is, and act like they have a plan moving forward. Again, show me a plan. Show me something that you want to do. Show me that you were, or that you actually know what it takes to reinstate winning, to reinstill this, to reinvigorate the old lady right now. Because right now, Juventus football feels like it is dead. I know it's not dead, but it feels that way right now. Like the passion that I feel like the fans, we've been whittled away and we've been worn down season after season after season. You can do this for a couple seasons, but we're damn near 4 seasons in right now, and our passion is starting to like to wane. Like, when I say wane, I don't mean like love for the club. I'm saying the invigoration to get up every day for these game days, to do games. There's a reason why we haven't had a lot of watch-alongs and stuff lately. Who the hell wants to do a watch-along? I'll be sitting there saying nothing. I'll be talking about the freaking Marvel movie or something like that instead of the game, because there's nothing of substance to talk about. There's no interesting factoid I could give. There's nothing. I don't have it. Hopefully you give us something that'll make it worth it. Something that'll make us have enjoyment once again with these teams. I don't know what else to say. That's all I have right now. We'll see how this last game goes. Hopefully Juventus pull out a win, I guess, for moral victory at the end. But outside of that, there's not much really to go off on at the end of the season. I'm waiting right now for the game that will be played. Supposedly, we will know from Agresti, June 15th, which is the game of who will be the next coach of Juventus, or is it going to continue to be Max Allegri? And we will have many thoughts to go from there. Guys, let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you haven't already, do me a solid favor. Smash the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit that bell icon to stay notified for all of our latest videos. Just a reminder again, also, if you could pop over, subscribe to the podcast channel we have over there. Link to that will be in the description down below as well. Thank you guys. I'll see you all next time. Forza Juve, Forza Bianconeri. Say hello to your old lady for me.